As many of you might already know, DJI recently released the first major firmware update for the Osmo Action 5 Pro. The standout feature of this update is the addition of a high bitrate mode, which has been by far the most requested feature by users. There are already many videos covering this in great detail, and for that reason, it won't be the focus of this video. However, I can say that after watching those videos and doing my own comparison tests, the difference is very subtle, but it is at least reassuring to have this option, and it alleviates concerns about image quality being affected by heavy compression. Another request that has been floating around a lot is for an adjustment to the normal color mode. Currently, the normal color mode has an aggressive HDR look that can appear cartoony and somewhat unnatural. This hasn't been addressed in the new firmware update, and because of this, I'll continue to use the D-Log M mode along with the official DJI LUT, which I find produces more natural and pleasing colors. However, one thing that stood out to me in the update notes was the mention of optimized stabilization performance when recording videos with slow shutter exposure. I hadn't seen any videos go into this in detail, so before updating the firmware, I wanted to get some slow shutter footage to test against the new firmware. To do so, I recorded some walking footage with the shutter speed deliberately set to a slow 1/60th of a second. Now, setting aside the fact that the footage is overexposed because I don't own ND filters for the Osmo Action 5 Pro, you can clearly see that the footage is a bit hard to watch due to the jittering that occurs with each step. Now let me show you what happens after I updated the firmware. The strange jittering issue has been resolved, and the footage is now much more usable. After comparing the footage more closely, I think I've figured out what DJI adjusted in the update. Previously, the RockSteady stabilization was very rigid, trying to keep the footage steady at all costs, leading to a jittery effect as it struggled to handle the motion blur in each frame. With the new update, the stabilization is noticeably toned down, allowing the camera movement to be more natural and pronounced compared to the floaty footage I was getting before. The benefit of this reduced stabilization is that those distracting motion artifacts are now much less noticeable. So, following on from that, I wanted to see how this change affected night footage, where the Action 5 Pro typically selects a slow shutter speed when shooting in full auto. Once again, I noticed a similar pattern. Here's some footage I took a couple of weeks ago with the old firmware. You'll see there's noticeable ghosting and blurring in these night shots. With the updated firmware, the issue is less pronounced, but the footage is also shakier. Now, to be fair, this isn't a perfect comparison because I was riding faster and more aggressively in these new shots. Still, I think it's enough to show that DJI has slightly reduced the stabilization strength at lower shutter speeds, making blurring less of a problem. So what do you think? Is the increased camera shake a worthwhile trade-off for clearer footage? Personally, I believe it is. While camera shake is usually seen as a drawback, it can add a sense of speed and immersion, and we as viewers are pretty used to seeing some camera shake in videos, unlike the weird blurring or jittering which stands out as some technical issue with the camera that was used.